Hey everybody, welcome back for another video. Today we're going to be doing a little bit of work with a system known as a zeolite. I think the system is called Chabazite, something to that effect. Basically, this is a material that serves as a sort of host guest material. You can think of it similar to a MOF, which is a molecular organic framework. Basically, this is a sort of porous solid that takes up guests, so to speak, which can be, for example, fuel emissions, cations, various types of things. So hydrogen storage. So it's a very versatile system, and it's used very commonly. It's also an emerging system in solid state physics. And so I hope you enjoy. Today we're going to be making a supercell of a zeolite, and we're going to add some vacuum. So first thing I'm going to do is open my system, which is this Chabazite system. And so here I don't have any cations or any guest materials. It's just the framework. And so what we're going to do is we are going to expand this one unit cell in the C dimension. And then we're going to add vacuum in the C dimension. And what we want to do is we want to end up with a set of coordinates and unit cell vectors that we can plug into our electronic structure software packages. And so I have other videos where I show this sort of process, but what happens is when there are new systems, things can get a little complicated, and so I hope to guide you guys and girls through this. So all right, let's go. So here's our Chabazite framework. It's silicon dioxide framework, and what we want to do is we want to expand along this C dimension, which is the dimension we are looking at now, which means that we're eventually going to have to destroy periodicity in the B and A dimensions. So the first thing we have to do is increase the C dimension by one unit cell. So we're going to actually transform our coordinates by just doing a magnification. So to do this, we go to Edit, Edit Data, Unit Cell, then we go to Transform, and we're going to transform the we're going to magnify the C axis by 2. So then we press OK. Yes, let me turn off my volume here. Then we press OK, apply. So there we go. So that's pretty straightforward. We officially have a supercell, quote unquote. So let's go ahead and save this. We are going to go to File, Export Data, and we're gonna write down the unit cell coordinates now. So it's a 1x1x2 supercell. So we press Save, Partition Coordinates. Okay, let's go into our viewer, and you can see our structure now. And you can see that the C dimension is quite large. Now it's 29. If I go back into the other one, it's 14.7. So you can see that we have effectively doubled our C dimension. But this is, we are far from done at this point. So let's go back to Vesta. And I'm just going to close this with Control W and reopen it. Okay, so here is our zeolite, which we've expanded by one unit cell in the C dimension. So now what we're going to do is the first step is we have to delete all of the atoms that lie outside of the unit cell. And so to do this, let's go to the C. And so when we press C up here, it will have us looking downwards at the C dimension. So let's delete every atom that falls outside of the unit cell, as far as we can see it here. Then I'm just going to rotate this. Okay, and I don't rotate it until I get back to where I started, and I don't see anything else. So now I'm going to look at it at a different view, which is this B. And I'm just going to rotate it again until I wind up where I started. And I don't see anything. Same thing with A. I don't see anything. Okay, so there weren't that many atoms that fell outside of the unit cell, just those couple in the C dimension. So now what we have to do is we have to delete the atoms that would be double counted by the unit cell. So what do I mean by that? Let's go back into the A-frame. So here is our unit cell. Here's our supercell. And what we need to envision first is where the vacuum is going to go. So the vacuum is going to go along the C dimension. That means that we must preserve the periodicity along the C dimension as it stands for this unit cell. So basically what I'm saying is this. Let's take a quick detour to the B dimension. So in the B dimension, if I were to plug this into the electronic structure software package, you can see that these atoms here are the same. Oh no, sorry, not those ones. These atoms here are the same, right? So if I were to put these atoms into the electronic structure software package, it would typically crash because I'm giving the same atom twice. So what I need to do is I need to delete one of these atoms before putting it in the code in the electronic structure software packages. This way I sort of account for the periodicity already. Otherwise I'll have too many atoms in my system. And so we need to do this for all of the dimensions in which we want to have periodic. Now, because we do not want the C dimension to be periodic, we actually need to keep it appearing to be periodic here. So I'll go ahead and do that and show you what I mean. So first, let's look down the C dimension, the dimension where we want the vacuum. And what we're going to do is we are going to delete the periodicity occurring in the B axis, so this axis. So keep that in mind. Let's look at the B axis and see where we have periodicity. So we have it for these two atoms here. Okay, so deleted those. We do not have it for these two here. We do seem to have it for these two here. Well, actually, it was quite tricky. We also have it for these two here. We do not have it for these silicon atoms. So the periodicity seems to be just for the oxygen atoms. So it will be for these two and these two. Okay, so that is periodicity in the B dimension. Now we need to do periodicity in the A dimension. So I shift it here. So now if I go left to right, I'm doing periodicity in the A dimension. So you can see it's going to be in the oxygens again, and you can kind of see where it's going to be. So we'll start, we'll stick to one side this time. So these go to here. These go to here. These oxygens go to here. These oxygens go here. And these oxygens go here. And let's just get rid of this as well. Okay, so if you look back and see now, we basically destroyed this periodicity in the A and B dimensions. Let's just sort of double check. Yeah, I think it looks good. Although you never know until you basically get to the end. Yeah, I say this looks good for now. I can't find any atoms that are repeating on the A and B axis. So example, like for here, there's no atoms here. For these oxygen atoms, there's none here. Now, the question is, there are some atoms repeating in the C dimension. For example, this atom may repeat with this atom. This is fine because this is the dimension where we want to add the vacuum. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to File, Export Data, and I'm actually going to export it as an XYZ file. So this is very important. So now I press Save. Do not save the hidden atoms. And now we have our XYZ file. What I'm going to do is I'm now going to make a text file, and I'm going to call it CHA1x1x2 vacuum.vasp. Save it. I'm going to go to my previous VASP file, and I'm going to copy in the first couple lines to here. Now we want to add, let's add 20 angstroms of vacuum in the C dimension, so we'll just make this a 4. We don't know how many atoms we have, so I'm going to leave that blank for now. And let's go into our XYZ file. Now we have 246 atoms. I'm going to copy the atoms. Now there's something I noticed. You see how we have, if I go back up to the top, we have oxygen atoms, and then silicon, and then oxygen. I actually don't like this, so I'm going to take the oxygens and just keep them all into one group. So now I have to count the number of oxygens that I have, and to know you got this right, you should preserve the SiO2 framework. So here I'm going to count the oxygens. I have 9. And 182. So I take out my trusty calculator. 182 minus 9 plus 1. I have 174 oxygens. Now I have to count the silicon. 183, 254, 172. Okay, so it does look like we have significantly more oxygen than we should. So I am just going to keep this in mind for now. Maybe we should have this because of the vacuum. Could be the case. Yeah, I think this is the case because of the supercell. But let's just keep this in the back of our mind for now, that maybe this should be 144, or whatever 72 times 2 is. So now let's delete these. Okay, so we have our file. Let's go back here, open, vacuum.vasp. So it's going to be a pretty big cell. Now you can see. So I think this looks this looks correct. One way to see if it's correct is to line it up. Let's line it up along A. Let's actually rotate it slightly so it's like this. Actually, yeah, this is fine. You can just get rid of these. And then let's take our original structure. And see how we do. So it should be the same as this. So I'm going to take a snippet. Okay, let's see. So far we're good here. We look pretty good here. So it looks good to me so far. Let's rotate it now and take one more snippet. So we have these oxygens, this oxygen here, these clusters, even though that you can't tell the depth. So these aren't, you know, too close together. So it looks fine to me. I think what happened with this SiO2 sort of breaking, or maybe it's not SiO2. Let's see if 174. Okay, so it's some weird 2.4. I think what happened is because of the, we have a supercell that's, you know, it's not, if this was 2 by 2 by 2, then it, maybe the SiO4 should hold. But because we have this like 112 supercell, it might not hold. So everything looks fine. I think at this point, what I would look to do is, I would look to think about like doing electronic structure calculations on here and see if I can reproduce some bulk properties. Of course, you have the vacuum effect. Let's go ahead and expand this in the A and B dimension and see what our surface looks like. Looks pretty good. I'm going to go ahead and do that a couple more times. Delete this stuff up here. I think this looks pretty good. So what you would do is you would basically do this whole process, but maybe you'd have your atoms in here already, like the sodium ions, the calcium ions. Yeah, and then if you wanted to reduce the vacuum, you would basically just do it here. And let's also do one more quick sanity check. So we have 174 plus 72 is 246. So if we go into our XYZ file, we should have 246 in here. We do. So yeah, I think the breaking of the SiO2 may be due to this strange supercell arrangement. But in any case, that's the tutorial today. This would be the 001 surface of the zeolite. So if I go to edit, lattice planes, new, and I do 001, and I make it 0, let's do actually 0.6. Oh, perfect. You can see that this is the 001 unit cell plane of our system. So thanks for watching. If you have any suggestions, or if you, you know, caught an error I made, please let me know. I can remake the video. Yeah, thanks. Take care.